This is likely going to be a long video. So grab a drink, have a bit of a stretch, and we'll meet you right back here. Ready? Let's get started. Hey kids, I'm Kamau.
I'm Selena.
And we're with The City and Beyond. Earlier this year, we had a video telling you what flying was like during the pandemic. Now we're going to tell you what flying is like in the pandemic, but later in the year, I guess. The difference between earlier this year and now.
And we're also gonna talk about international travel.
Without further ado, let's get started. First on our list, lounges.
So last time when we went to our Southwest trip, which was last December, we stopped in the lounge and we stayed there for a couple of hours before our flight. Last week on our way to Colorado, we stopped in the lounge again before we aborted our flight. And there were a couple of differences, not too many. One thing was
that they were a bit more laxed on the restrictions. Now, what do I mean by that? When we went earlier this year, late last year, there were people walking around. They say that you should only be dropping your mask if you're eating or drinking and then immediately put your mask back up. However, this time, they kind of just let you chill. And people were very respectable. If they got up to go get more food or get a drink or go to the bathroom, they put their masks up. But if they were sitting at the table, conversing with their family, friends, business partner, whoever, their masks were down, they were eating, watching movies, having a good time. No one really came by and said anything. However, when people did get up, people did come by to clean the table. Most times we went, we had morning flights, early morning flights, and then just regular like morning flights. And so it was breakfast both times. Food is still pre-packaged. I don't know what they're doing for lunch and dinner, but for breakfast, all the food is pre-packaged.
Onto boarding. TSA and check-in and all that stuff is pretty much the same as it's been. Boarding has changed because we remember a lot of airlines were doing boarding by seat, like your row. If you were in the last row, you boarded first and then they filled up to the front of the plane. That is no longer happening. I don't think that's happening on any airline currently.
Earlier in the year when we took our flights, they gave us like a mini amenity pack. So you had alcohol wipes, a bottle of water, and maybe some cookies. And if you were lucky, they came around and asked if you wanted some coffee or tea, right? Now, they just give you the alcohol wipes and then the beverage cart is back. So you can get your soda, you can get your alcohol, you can get your snack boxes and still get your coffee and tea fix.
The middle seat wasn't restricted even when we did our last video.
Right.
It's definitely not restricted on any airline now. So pretty much if we think that there's gonna be an airline because of Delta variant or whatever, there's no middle seat empty anymore. And actually every single time we've traveled, the flight has been crowded. I even made like Instagram post about it where I'm like, I don't see these empty flights. Someone did say it's possibly because we're on domestic flights in the US. So a lot of Americans are flying domestically, but not internationally. So maybe that's why we're not seeing emptier flights. But I've flown from the beginning of the pandemic to now, and I think every single flight has been crowded.
There are still buses and trains and I guess boats. I'm not gonna go as far as cruises because that's a whole nother monster all to itself. But for the most part, from what we have seen, their restrictions are still in place. If it has changed, let us know.
Capacities are limited on trains. Like when we took Amtrak earlier this summer, it was limited capacity. And I believe they still do have limited capacity.
Yeah.
And they also show on when you buy your ticket, what percentage of the capacity the train is at, so that you can decide for yourself whether you wanna buy your ticket. And I think the buses are doing the same thing. I don't know if every single company is doing that, but for the most part, a lot of companies for buses and trains are still limiting capacity regardless of COVID restrictions being lifted. Before we continue, if you're new here, The City and Beyond is a brand that provides part-time travel advice and inspiration to full-time employees so that they can utilize their time off.
So if you'd like to show support, subscribe to this channel now and remember to click the notification bell so you can enjoy some more of our videos. So now we'll talk about reasons why we have contemplated and ultimately decided not to fly international this year. If you were looking forward to us having our big big international trip, which if you followed us long enough, you know that we do at least one a year. I'm sorry to disappoint. We'll see you next time. Thank you for the watch time. Right? But we have decided not to go international this year, and we'll tell you what we were contemplating and then the reasons why we ultimately decided not to go.
Number one thing was FOMO. I am not too big of a person to admit that I had FOMO. And looking at my Instagram, whatever, social, TikTok, whatever, I definitely noticed other travel content creators traveling the world and going to Europe, going to Africa, going to wherever, Asia, and enjoying their best lives. Not that I'm not enjoying my best life, but I definitely felt like, man, we had so many plans and it's gonna be year two of not going anywhere internationally, not even Canada. And if you know us well, we love Canada. And
yes,
we love visiting there. We even got married there. And we haven't been able to go back since our wedding, actually.
Very true.
And so it has been hard to like look at people's content and not feel some sort of FOMO of just like, man, I'm really missing out. And definitely missing out on these empty places, you know, places that are usually so crowded. This seems like a pretty optimal time to really get to enjoy these places. And I think of places like Rome. Rome is a very crowded touristy place.
Yeah.
There's so many crowds and getting through people. And right now it's a lot less than it usually is.
I don't know if you've searched these things, but like if you go to Trevi Fountain, there's almost no one there and it's always jammed. Packed. And I would imagine that if you went to places like the Louvre, there's constantly like a long gaping like rock star type line to see the Mona Lisa. I feel like at this point you can walk up and touch it. That is extremely, extremely appealing. And that has weighed heavy on us on whether or not we should go, because we've been dubbed as fast travelers, right? We're kind of like a wham bam thank you ma'am when we see things like, oh, this is what we came to see. See it? Picture? Picture of us, prove that we were there, and then it's time to go. With no one really being around, I would be able to see a lot more because I wouldn't need to wait in line or anything.
The other thing is bucket lists, countries, cities. Whatever. I have to say, I don't really have a bucket list, but there are places that I want to go to. And having 2 years of not being able to go to any of them and no progression and increasing the amount of countries we've been to is kind of hurtful. Because like we're looking at other people and we're seeing their numbers increase and we're just like, I would like to go to more. And so I want to go to Morocco. I want to go to Africa, period. And obviously 2 years out means
the many countries of the African continent.
Yeah, I want to go to Africa, period. And having 2 years just gone doesn't help me get any closer to that,
right?
Example. So that was actually a strong driving force to really be like, oh, you should just go, just pick a country. But we also started to settle.
Throw a dart. We're going there.
Yeah, we also started to settle, which we'll talk about in another point. But that was like a big, like, we should just go somewhere so we could progress towards, you know, our country exploration goal.
And a lot of the places that I was like, oh, one day I would love to go, I have been to. I always wanted to go to England. I have been there with my wife. Well, we've also gone to Italy, another place I would have loved to go. Since I was about 16, I said, if I ever got married, I'm going to New Zealand for my honeymoon. Spoilers, we did. Dreams do come true, kids. There are going to be more places that I want to go to. There are more places that I want to go to. And some of them I thought I would have been to by now.
Yeah.
But given everything that's happening right now, the bucket list will have to wait.
And our third point about this, one of the things we had contemplated is that, and I'm sure a lot of people are thinking this, is that life is too short.
Right.
Life is short. With this last year and a half, 2 years, I think this has been very, very clear to people. And we've thought to ourselves, if we're gonna get sick, we're gonna get sick. Like if it's here or if it's in, you know, Uganda, like it's gonna happen. So
yeah.
We also contemplated like just going for it.
So the reasons why we ultimately decided not to go international for this year, 2021, for all those watching in the future, which inevitably is always the future.
We'll see about 2022.
The number one reason was health and safety, not just of ourselves, but of our family as well. Reader's Digest version, Selena and I both come from Caribbean families, and as a result, and I'm sure it's with other families as well, but specifically I can speak for Caribbean households. We are caretakers for people in our families, part-time, oldest sibling-wise, whatever you want to make it to be.
Fun fact, we're both the oldest.
Yeah. For whatever reason, a lot of events have happened this year concurrently. Thankfully, nothing that has like really put the fear in us, or even COVID related for that matter. But a lot of it has happened concurrently. A lot of events, life events, health-wise and otherwise, some celebrations, some joyous, some a new beginning. And for their health, giving everything that's happening along with us and their safety and everything that's happening to them, and our health and everything that's happening in the world and our safety with everything happening in the world, it was probably the wisest decision for us not to go anywhere, to miss things, to endanger them, and or to have to rush back, which knock on wood, we thankfully have not had to do in any of our trips.
I mean, as part-time travelers, I'm sure that you're having similar discussions where it's just like, do I really want to do that to, you know, my friends and family, and, you know, jeopardize coming back from those countries. We saw what happened in 2020, coming back from other countries, potentially affect or infect others and jeopardize their health and safety, and we didn't think that it was worth it in that regard.
Hand in hand with that brings us to our next point, restrictions.
Oh yes.
So if you know us, if you've been watching this channel long enough, you know that if there is one country we absolutely love, it's Madagascar. I'm joking, it's Canada. It's Canada. We absolutely adore Canada. How much do we love Canada?
We love Canada.
It's been tough, right? because Canada is our little Europe, and we really enjoy it. We really, really enjoy it. We love the people. I've got lots of friends on every coast and in the middle, and I can't see anybody. The restrictions to enter Canada are kind of the worst of both worlds. Not only do you need to be vaccinated, you need a negative test, and I believe you still need to quarantine for a bit, and you have restricted travel to where you can go. Also, the US border incoming is technically closed to outsiders. Since we're Americans, we can obviously get back in, but do you really want to deal with the kerfuffle? I personally do not, and YouTube has been killing me because they keep sending us these ads saying Canada is open. I'm like, I know, but not completely.
And honestly, the restrictions, like Kamal mentioned earlier, like we're fast travelers, like, and I assume most of our audiences, you probably fast travel. Right. It's a week long, it's 2 weeks long, it's not months or a year long trip. So with that said, like, doing all these restrictions and then only staying there for but so much time also didn't seem very sensible. Like, why put ourselves through all this? Why potentially get rejected because we forgot something and put ourselves through this? I would be in such a bad mood. I feel like it would just start off my trip in such a negative space. Like, you're already stressed out from work, you're already stressed out from life, you know, caregiving, family stuff, home stuff, whatever. And then you go on this trip and you have an added layer of things, and you're like, yes, but at least I'll be in fill in the blank. And if that doesn't happen, or if things don't turn out the way you planned, how annoying would that be? And waste of money, honestly. So there's just so many layers to the restrictions that I'm like, I totally understand and agree why they're in place. But as a part-time traveler, just didn't seem to make financial or just like mental sense.
Yeah.
Because it would just put us through so much, and it's all to relax, but then it's not relaxing. Like, it kind of contradicts why we travel.
Yeah, if you've been at your job for a little while, then you've got 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks of travel, and those days need to count. right? And if you've got like life events coming up, then you know some of those days are gonna get eaten away.
Yeah,
and you need to be able to utilize them appropriately. And we know a couple of people that have been back and forth over the border a couple of times and they've had a good time. We know people that have gone to Europe while all this has been going down and they've been having a grand old time. And again, more power to them, you do you, but like for us, it's not the time. And if I'm being completely honest and transparent, I have not had a COVID test as of yet, and the thought of having a Q-tip stuffed in my nose is just like, nah, I'm good on that. I'm completely good on that.
But we do quarantine.
We quarantined
a lot
in
the past year and a half. We did get the vaccination if you missed that post. I'm pretty sure we put it in like a story or something. We were starting to compromise. We're like, okay, so what countries don't have many restrictions, which is probably the worst way to think about this. But we started to think about that. Like, okay, like we don't need a test. Okay, we have our vaccine. So which countries will just take us as we are? And like, maybe we'll go there. And it's like, it's not that we didn't want to go to those countries. It was just like, right now, that's not really what's driving me. Like we usually pick places that we're like, yeah, we should go there. Like, that's where we should go.
Right.
And it feels right. And we were starting to be like, oh, well, people are in Bali, people are in Turkey. And like, yeah, the restrictions don't look that bad. And it was just like, no, that's not how we travel. And that is settling and we don't want to do that. And obviously the last thing was we decided to stand up to FOMO.
Pretty much.
FOMO is not going to dictate where we go and how we get there. And so we decided that as much as we're looking at these beautiful videos from Santorini and Tuscany and everywhere else, and seeing these videos and photos with people, I'm just like, ugh. We're just like, you know what? FOMO is not taking us down.
No.
We're gonna be patient, and honestly, exercising patience is
a huge part of
part-time travel. Yeah. I think that not a lot of people are talking about the fact that like, oh, these are hard decisions to make. And I'm sure that your family members and friends probably think you're crazy that this is a hard decision to make.
Yeah.
But it is a hard decision to make, and we totally understand where you're coming from.
Absolutely.
And we've had these discussions, and we're actually interested to hear in the comments section, what discussions are you guys having in your family about international travel?
Like this video if you like us, share it with a friend, remember to subscribe, click the notification bell, and
we'll see you next week.
Bye.